Okay, a little Monday afternoon ride in Orange County. Had to drop my YZ450F off at my brother's shop, Enzo Racing, so they could put it back to stock, as we are getting the 2025 model bike next week. So that means I have to give back my 24. But called up old mountain bike Ben, see if he wanted to get a ride in. Of course he said yes, he rides here every day. But I'm a little early, so I'm gonna get a couple runs on a trail they call Why Not, I think. Go check it out. Yeah, hopefully I don't eat shit like the last time I was on a mountain bike. But if you like my gloves, they are from Saints of Speed. I encourage you to check them out on Instagram or their website. They make a lot of cool, fun stuff. And they actually fit really well. There's a couple other glove specialists that make stuff, and the thumb is always too long for me. So anyway, perfect fit. And fun design. This one's called Samurai. Has the old rising sun, cherry blossoms, and a armored up Japanese warrior. It is crazy what a difference a few weeks makes. These are wild artichokes, and I'd say a month ago these were all purple and white and really pretty looking. Obviously they're super vicious because they have these horrible spikes on them that can ruin your day. And but yeah, now they're dry and even more ugly and evil looking. Okay, so this trail is called Why Not. Done it once before, maybe twice. Some jumps on it. Oh, a little shorty. Yeah, I realized last week I didn't ride my mountain bike at all. Mostly because I ate shit the week before. I had a big fat black eye. But trail's pretty fun. Whoa! Wasn't good. I'm gonna get another black eye. Oh, mandatory gap there. Somewhere around here there's like a wood ramp. Ooh. Dude, the ground is so dry and slippery. Trail closed. Well, sorry. Whoa! Trail slippery is what I should say. Oh man, I'm bummed I didn't hit that one little double back there. Might have to go back and do it. So the only bunk thing about this trail is you have to climb back up this kind of funky canyon. And I don't know if the GoPro will pick up on it, but it's solid buzzing right now from all the bees in these plants. Let's see if you can hear. I think they must be in these plants, because this sure ain't got anything sweet. Anyway, let's hope I don't get stung in the face. Okay, ride has come to a premature end. Dude, that's pretty bad when the chain is in two pieces. Wow. I have one master link, but I don't have two. I'm gonna have to call Benny and tell him abort mission. Damn, that sucks. This is when a full powered 50 plus pound e-bike sucks. Oh my goodness. Can't wait to get my personal bike back from Magic. Ride that thing, it doesn't snap chains. Ooh, so much excitement. Falling us down in fire. Ooh. Anyway, yeah, I'm bummed. I wanted to ride with Benny. For real. So impressive how much he has improved. He's into it, that's for sure. Talking about buying special parts for his bike, upgrading his suspension. Heard a rumor that Kyle Barra has a mountain bike now too, so that should be super fun. Riding with both the guys from Bell. Oh, I missed my turn. Can't pedal, gotta push. Like a skateboard, channeling my inner Steve Caballero. Anyway, this sucks. Okay, we're at Glen Helen today on Thursday, and riding the super potent KTM 350. Got my dog. Mattia is here from a 5-week World Series of Love tour.
That's right. Here we go.
You got Talon coming out today?
Your gas door is open.
Talon coming out?
No. But 5 weeks. Chasing his girlfriend around the world. You know, like,
it was only around Europe, not around the world. Come on now.
Fanboying and
track snack.
Yeah, he's the track snack.
I was a track snack.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then here I am with no track snack myself.
And this is actually the first time Mattia's ever driven himself to the track because he finally bought a truck. He's always sponge rides off me or had his dad or friends. I didn't know that you guys had this trick window now.
I didn't know either.
That's pretty badass.
Yeah, it's
And your
fine.
Truck is dialed in by what, ORW?
Yeah, Off-Road Warehouse, good old Greg Adler.
Look at that. Hey, Greg Adler, I think you should sponsor a property on swapmotolive.com. We'll put ORW on the butt of our pants, you know? We got the dumb dog tangled up. Come on, Nisa. Be smarter than the easy up. Dahmer is testing the Bill's pipes. What is it called? RW13? RE13 system. Full system for the Husqvarna FC450. Got his fresh new matrix stand. I think the double stickers is kind of gay. What do you think? Comment below. Tell him he's lame. Well, that was a short day. I didn't get on the track. Started the bike up, it was making a knocking sound, and I think the timing chain might have broke. Anyway, short day. Friday's at Fox, and there's like a Thor van parked here. Is that even allowed? Are you even allowed to be here with a Thor van at
Hell
Fox?
Hell yeah, take all my photos here in front of all the Fox stuff. Yeah. Maybe we gotta do it.
Man, you got a van packed full of goodies in here.
You know, like,
it's because Thor sells out, right? It's all sold out.
Every season, man. Huh?
Do you have anything with the new logo here?
Not a little bit.
You have a set of gear with the new logo?
A little bit, let me show you.
Yeah,
let me show you this. I gotta show you.
So I enjoyed the rebranding we talked about on the podcast last week.
Oh yeah, yeah. Thank you for the spot. So talking rebranding, talking next gen, as we like to call it. So, you know, people are kind of seeing these, our riders, they went out to all our riders, you know, Bitchin' Media, Associates, etc. But kind of talking about our next generation, bit of the new logo got it going on, so a little bit of that, and you know, hats, tees, little goodies and stuff like that. But really, it's all about the story, you know. So talking about, you know, it's kind of cheesy, but it's, you know, welcome to the next gen, we've been expecting you. I mean, you know, it's just, it's something that we put a lot of thought, a lot of effort into. It's it kind of emphasizes the fact that over at Thor, I mean, we're, you know, we're all passionate about it. Like, yeah. Everybody there rides something, whether it's motorized, bicycle, etc.
Dude, Kowalski doesn't ride shit.
He hauls on a mountain bike. I'm not kidding.
He does not.
I am not kidding. Surprised the shit out of me this year. We went for a team ride up at Vail.
He won't.
And I was like chasing him. I'm like, dude, who are you, man? You're too huge for that.
Well, he's got those big giant Korean calves, you know?
That's what it is. Powers up those hills. So.
Okay, so let me ask you this. The icon, this new icon, it replaces that icon.
That's correct. Correct? Yep. So
is this derived from this?
Exactly-ish. So it can be related there. I mean, don't get me wrong. There are people with, you know, tattoos of that and the mask.
But I mean,
I
saw that immediately as a mask.
Exactly right. We have to have that. We have to have that lineage there going along, that progression of the branding and of the logo that people still understand and respect, but also like a stylized T, you know, the capital of Thor, obviously.
I think it's clean and it's more modern, you know?
Yeah.
Because that half, I liked when you cut it in half because it used to be a full with a circle around it, right?
Yep, correct.
Yeah, so it was a nice change when it went to the half mask, and I think this is pretty cool. It's very abstract, but it's cool.
Exactly right. That's the thing is, you know, think about it, man. Like during the last, you know, 20, 25 years, give or take, with the advent of the movies and the kind of growth of the comic side of things, it's better for us to kind of more separate ourselves from that. With all due respect, the movies are awesome, Marvel's amazing, all that, but I mean, that's not who we are. We're a sport and athlete oriented company with progressive products, technical products. We need to talk more in our own vein, our own story. So the further we can separate from the comic side of things, it makes more sense to our fans and followers.
It's funny because obviously this started off as Hallman, and then Torsten Hallman original race where it became Thor, and so like it's been cool to see the progression of the name and the icons and all that. And it's funny because I think icon is important for a brand that's separate from just the word mark, right? Because like when we started Transworld Motocross, right, we came out with that little shield, and we got that shield on riders' helmets before the magazine dropped, and it was on the cover of Dirt Rider on Ezra Lusk's helmet. I loved it. And it debuted at the Indy Trade Show, and they're handing that magazine out. We're, look, here we are.
That's what kind of this month building up to our launch, because our official launch is next week still in August, right? So, but this month of July, it's more just about that. Not about bringing out the word and letting people know exactly what it is right out the gate. I wanted people to worry about us a little bit. Who do these guys think they are? Is this a new brand? Who's on Star Racing right now? Things like that.
Yeah.
I wanted people to, you know, kind of take a step back and take a minute to really soak it in. Like you said, you made some good points about the relation to the old and coming to the new and the progression therein. And, you know, I just wanted people to worry just for a second what was going on with us. So,
nice. Awesome. So, what we got going on today? You guys are riding
Boys
starts?
Are here. Yeah. So, we're going to get some time on some Vargs, right? So, I mean, hey, I'm still a two-stroke oil burner guy myself, but I'll tell you, man, I rode one recently. I don't want to say change the game. I want to say, holy cow, just super fun right out the gate and can't wait to race one next week.
It's like a different sport, I feel.
Sure.
Because it's easier and it's so different. It's like a sit down jet ski compared to a stand up.
Sure. Yeah.
that's what I like.
Not much of a sit down guy, but I get what you're saying. You jump on, you go, you take a few laps, you warm up that first moto to kind of feel it out, like how it works with the throttle, how it works with the brakes, when you can use it to adjust the curve into corners and things like that. I don't know if I'm using those terms correctly. The start guy can tell you, but it's just once you start feeling it, you start flowing with it. These things are bitching, man. I love it. So.
Cool. Well, we'll see you out there, Shorter.
Right on.
Good to see you.
Yeah.
Oh, Scrubby.
Hey, this thing's sick. It looks so good in person.
Oh my God, dude. They did such a nice job.
No, that is a nice bike.
Like, they changed it. So, this used to be silver, Scrubby.
Matches his bike.
Yeah, but all he gonna do is wreck it the first thing.
What? No, this is old, dude. I put that on.
Man, are you gonna lay it over?
Fuck yeah, I'm gonna crash it.
I don't know.
That's why I got the clear. So,
hey, you even got people asking me, hey, he likes this motor.
Blood in the sun, so you can see the shimmer.
How is this so light with
that
motor
in here?
Oh, yeah.
Look at the candy in that fork, dude.
Gee.
I think you should do more gold.
No.
Maybe do gold bars.
No.
That,
dude, the track's so good.
That thing in the back caught me off guard.
Man. Man, this thing's fucking ridiculous.
It's so good, huh?
So we're leaving Fox. My GoPro battery died, so I don't have very much, but I did fall in the mud and get all muddy. But Chase and I, we filmed a video with this guy Tom Lee,
who, dude's ripped. No homo, but
huh,
no homo, but he's ripped.
Yeah, right. It's like a fucking Chinese marine or something.
Chinese.
But yeah, we got to give this guy a helmet. Z1R Helmet sponsors this giveaway thing. And the guy's riding in hiking boots and regular pants and jerseys. So I told him I was gonna give him my kit. Whoa, 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 almost got taken out by my pump. But yeah, so I'm in a position where I'm very blessed with unlimited kits. So it's time to share the love. Size 9?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh man.
What are you riding in, dude? Those are like hiking boots.
Yeah, just hiking boots that I got for work.
Okay, so size 9.
Oh man.
32 large. It looks like 32 large,
yeah,
your size.
I'm the same.
Your dial. Just be warned, if you're wearing a jersey with my name on it, people might throw rocks at you.
No, I have to represent.
They might be like, it's that Maeda guy, throw shit at you.
No, I'm going to put your name to shame out here in the kitty track. So
no way,
I'll try to represent the best I can.
No way. Well, okay, now your ankles are safer and your head safer.
I appreciate that so much.
It was great to meet you, Tom.
Yeah, likewise. Right. Hopefully I'll see you out here again.
See you out here again.
All right.
Actually, I need to get you some Swapmoto Live stickers for your bike. What do you think?
Okay.
Okay, I'll get some stickers. Okay, so our buddy Sean Lepanovich teaches motocross schools. He's famous for doing the Little Ladies of LA. So I always tease him about that. He has a student today that's 66-year-old Japanese lady. Are you Sean's?
Huh?
Is Sean teaching you to ride?
Yeah. I'm trying.
How long have you been riding?
Off and on for like probably like 15 years, but at the track about 3 years.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. So Sean is giving you lessons today?
Well, Sean used to coach my grandson.
Okay.
So I knew, and then after I broke my collarbones and all that kind of stuff, and I got a hold of him, and he said, yeah, you know, you just need to be safe, so yeah.
No way.
I've been training with him for close to 3 years now.
And he said you're 60?
66.
66? are you Japanese?
Yes.
Japanese. Are you from Japan? Or
yes,
you?
I am.
Okay, how long have you been here?
I came in 1980, so 44 years.
Are you Issei?
No, I'm the first generation. I left everybody.
Okay, so first generation, isn't that Issei?
Issei is first. The second generation.
Yeah, so you're Issei. Yeah, Issei. I'm Yonsei.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, I knew you were Japanese.
Yeah. Crazy, huh?
I mean, you're...
Okay, so why do you want to ride motorcycles at 66 years old?
I mean, what else did I do? I tried like mountain bikes, climbing,
uh-huh.
You know, did all those, but this is it.
That's awesome. You have a CRF 150. Yeah. That's cool. I like your ramp setup. It looks easy to load. You just ride in?
No, well, that's what Sean tells me, but at home I'm still short in weeks. So I have to find the, incline.
Yeah.
Sean goes up when he's training me.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
So. Oh, that's awesome. So your grandson still rides?
No, he's in the army. Second grandson rides here and there, but uh-huh. Maybe like 2-3 times a month.
Do you tease him, say, I outlasted you?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yep, I always do. My bike has more hours than yours.
Where do you normally ride?
Everywhere, so here, Elsinore, Korea, because I live in Anza, and then Glen Helen.
Oh, that's awesome. Is your house safe right now with the fire?
Yeah, so it's Agwanga, so it's about, I don't know, 20 miles from my house.
Uh-huh.
So it's not too bad. I can see the fire, but...
Oh, okay. Wow, it was nice to meet you.
Oh,
man, is it hot here. We're at Jay Clark's house. Dunlop Tire, home of Dirt Bike TV. Gonna get a MX-14. Put on my spare KTM wheel, which is being held by teenage womanizer Aiden. And we brought Scrubby along because he says he cannot ride on this tire because it's so bald. He said he cannot possibly ride one more time on this tire. Okay. Look at all that tread on that tire, dude.
It's sliding.
It's sliding?
Man, that thing's slip and slide everywhere.
Slip and slide?
Be scrubbing to me.
Dude, look. This tire's brand new. It still has little nipples on the side.
Timed that so perfect.
Huh?
I timed it right when y'all came.
Why, you went to Dave's Hot Chicken?
No, right there. I was parked under a tree.
Oh.
Taking a little nap.
All right, unload this thing. Dude, look at, there's not even mud underneath. How'd you not hit the mud today?
Because I was going fast, bro.
Going fast to the snack bar. Come on, Gravy. Get that wheel off. There you go. Yeah. Oh. Hey, no lie. Is that the most you've ever worked on your bike?
Since yesterday.
Okay.
Now what I do?
Come on, let's bring it in. This will be the first time a black man has been inside this house.
I know, man. Huh? I didn't know. Look at how nice it is.
Come on, we're going to go this way. You've been here before, right?
Jay Clizzy.
Yeah.
I didn't even know he got the playground.
Yeah, dude, this is a estate. Dirt Bike TV. When you make all the YouTube money that Jay Clark makes,
you can live like this, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. AC in the garage?
Oh, yeah. Let's see, what are these?
What up, Scrubs?
Man, what's going on with this factory shop right here?
Dirt bike.
Look at that thing.
This is more airspeed right here. RMX 250?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be a Phillips head like that.
Ooh, look at this two stroke. Close the door. You're letting the cold air out.
Whoa.
You're letting the cold air out, man.
I thought he was behind me.
Who?
Hayden.
He's out there. He's out there talking about video games or something.
Bring it over here.
Oh, he gets first?
Well, I thought you said you wanted that one done.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I can leave mine.
And you took this one off a bike, right?
Yeah.
So let's do this one first. Okay. Put it back on the bike while I'm doing the other one.
Wait, now let me see. Assess the tread life on this tire.
Hey, he got his money's worth.
See?
You think it's used up?
See?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah, look at the
Jay would never use that.
Yeah.
I thought he was just being spoiled.
Yeah, he's being spoiled, but yeah. Okay.
Hey, man, this thing right here.
Hey, sexual chocolate, come pay attention so you know what to do.
I know, I do need to invest in one of these stands.
What? I said, dry your gear on?
Dry your gear. You guys know Jim? This is Jim, my buddy Jim.
Hi, Jim.
He's down from Palmdale for the day.
He's gonna spend the night and then go ride Glen Helen tomorrow on his way home.
Are you racing Glen Helen tomorrow?
No, I just ride.
I think they're racing on the main track.
Yeah,
I'll go over there. REM track? Arroyo Glen?
He rode there when it was Arroyo track, right, Jim?
Yeah, when I was a kid.
Yeah.
I actually raced it. I was like 13. What's going on?
How you doing?
Good.
That's a real 125.
Man, that was just a real slow 125. What I would call
the oh, these are some serious scissors. Watch this.
So I'm gonna keep the headlight.
Man, if you don't get out of here, with
that. Let me trim it. Let me trim it just a little bit.
No, you might trim too far.
Come on.
Trim it back his head.
Let's just make it flat on the bottom.
No.
Come on, just one snip, please.
No.
I'm getting you a tire. Come on.
Well, you want to do something.
You got me on to hold that right there, because we got busy talking about your career.
If you could check the pressure, it'd be the only time that tire is ever checked.
When are you riding this next bit, so I know what to get?
Tomorrow?
Set. Tomorrow. Where at? Fox. Fox?
I'm going to spank the 48. The 48 said he won't get business. So.
The 48's going to be in trouble?
Yeah, pretty much.
All right.
Lip flap.
Thank you.
I'm gonna watch him like install it back.
Yeah.
Install it back.
Install
it now on you're the talking back. Like me.
Yeah, right? I didn't say finna.
Oh, the homie left. How was he able to leave?
We moved your bike over.
What?
You didn't move it. You didn't pick it up.
Yeah, I did.
No, you did not.
Yeah, I did.
You dropped it.
No, he helped me.
All right,
here go to Horror Park.
Yeah, let's see this.
Wait,
what are you doing? I don't need a second angle on my vlog.
Huh. I'm filming for him.
No.
He told me to film for him.
That was at the track.
See. Let's see. Okay.
Watch. Man, look at you.
What?
You didn't close it.
I didn't do nothing.
Yeah, right.
whoa. It's not even lined up. Look.
Oh, yeah. No, because I'm going to put the chain on, then line it.
No.
Watch.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the NMI.
This guy does not know how to put a tire on.
Negro Mechanics Institute.
Hey, because you didn't close this.
I didn't do nothing, dude.
Man, now you... Now we're gonna need a wrench. I mean a screwdriver.
What are you talking about?
Hey, I saw him hit that brake, didn't you?
No.
Yo.
Boy, you walking home, man.
Yes, tell me out. Tell him everything.
Huh?
Hey, get a screwdriver. Huh?
What?
See, man.
I don't know. Yeah, sure,
you don't
bike.
Do anything?
No, watch. That's Here, we need a screwdriver.
Flathead?
No, because he can't do it like that.
Oh, yeah, I won't fit. Welcome to this week's mechanical tech tip presented by Scrub Daddy.
Yep, put this in there when you, and then you just kind of bumping that baby up like so.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then put that down, and then we go like this, and boom, we ain't like Flynn.
Boom,
pop that axle right through there. Ta-da.
Ta-da!
Look, told you, baby. Don't tell me I ain't a mechanic. Hey, I'm damn getting ready for 25. Wait. Man, what is going on here now?
You still need this?
What is he doing up there?
What?
He did nothing.
Hey, man. What did you do?
Nothing.
You did something. What in the world did you do this?
I didn't do nothing.
Why it ain't going back? Man, what is you doing?
You're using a screwdriver to pry it back? Watch out, fool. You just gotta go like this.
Ah!
It's not lined up right here.
Well, you've been working on these things for how long? Hey, I can't say I think you are pretty good. I see him do some stuff. It's
putting out the clutch. When I put your clutch in last week, I see you finish this up.
Yeah.
See you finish up the job.
Easy watch. All right, you always want to put this little black mark back up there. And the circle here goes like that, so you can put the...
The circle.
Yeah.
Then you put the circle on.
And then you just put this baby like so.
Okay, now what's next? What's next?
See, I could tighten the chain while I'm here, but I'm going to wait.
Careful.
And go like this. I'll be watching.
Oh!
I'll be watching the dirt bike shows.
Oh, yeah. I'm proud right now.
Yeah.
You do that? Why? Now, what's that in your hand? What's that in your hand?
A ratchet.
A ratchet.
Yeah.
Just like all them ladies, all your baby mamas. Ratchets. Oh, look.
Damn, this is craftsman, too. This is an old school one. I haven't even seen him make this kind.
He usually has snap-ons, man. Jay's a baller.
Like, he like you there.
Oh, no,
you, hey, you the biggest baller I know. Tell you, this boy got money. Look at that. Hey, man,
nice.
It's going to be trouble tomorrow. That tire looks so good, I don't even want to ride it.
Okay, we're going to do some arts and crafts with one of these. Just got to figure out how I'm going to do it. I think the O is good. How tire did you get?
Tire.
Well, it's my spare wheel. So let's check out your tire. What tire do you got?
Oh my God. What is CT?
Huh?
Man, what you? GT.
You got the Dunlop gravy train. Okay, we got our MX-14 mounted up on our spare KTM wheel for this bike. Dude, that tire is going to bust your teeth out tomorrow morning.
I ain't messing with that tire. You got to get it front first.
So we're in Laguna. Andre and I. Andre, the Corona resident Laguna local. Mm-hmm. I've only ridden here a handful of times, literally. And it's usually the people that know the trails. So I turn my brain off and follow. So I don't know my way around here that well. And as far as I know, we're going to do some trails today I've never done. One for sure I've never done. Ridden some stuff here with Lopes, but it's all illegal. So he says I can't Strava it or film it. So I have no memory or data to prove I've ridden here. So. New trails are so stressful, especially ones with rocks and drops and shit.
Kenny, I'm not that pumped on this bike.
following Honda's dust. Sunday morning. It's, what is it, 6:20 right now. I'm actually headed to the motocross track. A couple of them here in Southern California are opening really early on the weekends because it's been so hot. So I think the track opens at 7 today. And I'm meeting Chase and Dahmer and Ryan from Throttle Syndicate just to ride, what's this guy going, 10 miles an hour? Just ride maybe two motos, maybe three. I have to haul ass today out to Fountain Valley to pick up my brother Ross, and then we're gonna go to Granada Hills for a celebration of life for a guy named Eric Krippa, who is a long time Honda mechanic. I think he started off at Honda. I know that his big deal is he worked for Chuck Sun, who was a 500 national champion on the Honda HRC race team. I met Krippa in the early 2000s, and he was like the kind of like the Honda mechanic who took care of the motocross media. So I believe I started working with him when I was at Cycle News, and then also at Dirt Rider, and for sure when I started MX Racer and Trans World, I was working with Krippa as well. But he was always super fun. He was one of those guys that tinkered and tinkered and tinkered on the bikes. He was like the master of jetting a carburetor correctly. But yeah, we're going to his celebration of life today. I think it's gonna be a pretty casual thing because it's all motorcycle industry people. But there's several people that have been invited to stand up and speak a little bit about Eric. I'm one of them, kind of a little nervous, but actually I'm not gonna plan anything. I'm just gonna go from the hip because it's pretty easy to talk about your friends in a positive manner. So. Anyhow, we're good to get some motos. Brought the 350 KTM with me today. And yeah, let's hope it's a good day. Park next to Wayne. Man, you bring a picnic basket too?
Mm-hmm. What's that?
You got a picnic basket too? You got little thing and
picnic basket, yeah, everything. I got bologna sandwiches, everything.
Were you screwing the easy up into the ground?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's how hard the dirt is here. Just get some textures and
all right, I haven't been here in quite some time. How's the track?
Track's decent, you know, it's typical Paris. It's gonna be slippery.
Yeah.
And then it's hard packed, but the layout,
it's a different direction.
Oh, you haven't been to Chase's direction? Oh, I think this direction is way more vet friendly. The jumps aren't very steep. Pretty simple layout. Depends if they've ripped it. They've ripped it deep, it'll get nice and ready, but I don't know, it's been hard packed the last few times I've been here.
Scrubby said, I wasted my money.
He wasted your money? No, I would not say that. Riding dirt bikes, we have options in California, obviously. But, I mean, what's our option? We got Pala, Kahia, LACR, Paris.
Well, this is my option today.
Yeah, this
because is my option. Because they open at 7.
And, I live in LA. You know, I live in Downey. A lot of my friends are going to Pala, which I can go to Pala. But when I leave Pala, it takes me 3 hours to get home.
Traffic coming home from Pala is terrible.
It takes me 3 hours to get home, and you know, money is time to me. So if I spend 3 hours on the road, I'm wasting money.
Been here in a while. I am 55 now, but I still won't leave until I've at least tried all the jumps on a track. Now that one, oh my god, I can't believe I wasted all morning not trying it. Super easy. Anyway, got to get to that celebration of life now, so at least I did before I left. Won't bother me.